Let's now discuss how a transistor can be used as an oscillator. We can write that a transistor can be used in a circuit such that it continuously produces undamped oscillations at the output terminals of circuit. How it is possible? The basis is same what we have discussed in situation of transistor as an amplifier. The only difference is in this situation there is no input terminals in the circuit of an amplifier. Apart from output terminal is taken to the input side of the transistor. Let's first have a look on the circuit and then we'll discuss the mechanism how a transistor can be used as an oscillator. Here you can see the circuit in which we are using a transistor as an oscillator. And there's a common circuit in which transistor is being used with emitter common with base as well as collector terminals. Or there is similar to common emitter connections of a transistor. And between the input terminals B and E, here we have connected a tank circuit. This circuit with one inductor and a capacitor in parallel. We call it a tank circuit, which produces oscillations. And due to oscillations of voltage and charge in tank circuit, the base current fluctuates. And due to fluctuation in base current, the forward biasing of base emitter also varies periodically. And due to which collector current changes periodically, or more precisely we must say as LC oscillations are sinusoidal in nature, base current will also be sinusoidal varying and collector current will also vary sinusoidally. So if here collector current is varying sinusoidally, the output voltage here which can be written as ICRL will be a sinusoidal output which can be produced. And here this output voltage vary with the time in a sinusoidal fashion. And in this situation, for continuous oscillations in the tank circuit, some energy is required. And here we can see in this circuit, there is no battery or a DC sources applied in the input side. But for the same, we connect an inductor L2 in the collector circuit and we connect it mutually with the inductor L1 through a soft iron rod. And we know well that the soft iron rod will link the flux of inductor L2 to inductor L1. So here due to mutual induction between L2 and L1, a part of energy in the collector circuit will be linked to the base side of the circuit, and due to which the oscillation in the tank circuit will continuously sustain. And the amplified output of this tank circuit oscillations will be available at the collector side across the load resistance. So you will get the output. So here you can see in the whole circuit there are three sections. We can write that the circuit of oscillator consist of three parts. The very first one is, here you can see it is tank circuit which produces oscillations which are amplified by the transistor, and then collector side amplifier output is produced. The second one is obviously the amplifier circuit which is amplifying the small sinusoidal oscillations in the base emitter circuit which are being amplified, and on the output terminals we are getting it. The third one, which is very important, is called feedback circuit, because to amplify oscillations for the amplifier we need some energy at the tank circuit, and this energy is fed by the collector part. So this way by which a part of energy through the collector current is linked with the tank circuit via mutual induction, or we can say in form of magnetic energy, a part of output current energy is fed to the input side of the circuit. This part of circuit we call feedback circuit. In this situation, you can say when the flux in one coil increases, the other coil opposes the variation in current, or you can say phase variation takes place when it is fed to the other side. And when we talk about the output voltage, we know that in case of a common emitter amplifier, the output is always in opposite phase with respect to the input. So one phase variation takes place from input to the output side, and another phase variation takes place from output side to input side via feedback circuit. So here we can see that the feedback oscillations in this situation will be exactly in same phase as that of the nature of oscillations. That's why such kind of feedback we call positive feedback. And whenever the final output is in opposite phase, then it is called negative feedback. Let's discuss about the three circuits step by step in detail also. Let's discuss the three parts of an oscillator circuit, in which the first one we have discussed was the tank circuit, about which we can write that it is an LC oscillating unit, which we also term as tank circuit, and the frequency of such oscillations we know it is given by 1 by 2 pi root of LC, and we can see that this oscillating voltage across tank circuit act as input signal for amplifier circuit, which is amplified by the amplifier circuit. The second part is what we have discussed was the amplifier circuit in the oscillator. For amplifier circuit, we can directly write it is a normal common emitter amplifier, and it amplifies the oscillating voltage of the tank circuit, because tank circuit is connected at the input end of the transistor, that is across the base emitter junction of the transistor. And the third part, which is the most important section of this oscillator circuit, that we call feedback circuit. For feedback circuit, we can see that this section supplies a part of output energy from collector circuit to the tank circuit, which we have just seen in the previous diagram also. And here we can see that the output oscillations are in opposite phase with respect to oscillations of input voltage, which is across the tank circuit. And further we can write that due to mutual induction, again a phase shift of 180 degree takes place. We can see that 180 degree occurs, and hence the energy supplied to tank circuit as in same phase of its oscillations, and this is called positive feedback. So just keep this positive feedback also in mind. In your syllabi it is not going to be used, but you just keep in mind, whenever a part of output energy is fed back to the input circuit, And when it is being supplied to the input circuit, if it is in opposite phase with that of the input circuit, then that's termed as negative feedback. Here it is exactly in same phase due to again phase shift due to mutual induction. The phase of energy which is being fed is exactly same as that of input voltage oscillation. That's why it is termed as positive feedback.